I have the power. I have the power? Can I have the power, please?
Whee!
Hey guys, I'm back with another Masters of the Universe Classics review. And today I'm doing the evil master of escape himself, Webstor. Now, I definitely like this guy. I like the overall color for him. I think it's a very nice shade of blue. Just looks fantastic, and I think he'll look great among the others. You may notice he does not come with any kind of body armor. He does have some inside there, so don't worry. He's not going to be a naked beast all the time. Around here, show the back real quick. You get his bio here. Now, his bio's kind of interesting. The real names given to these characters are, for the most part, kind of hit or miss. You either get pretty good ones or just horrible ones. His is Arrhenius, son of Arrhenius. It works. It's not bad. And it pretty much says that his race, the Arrhenia, are extinct, gone. And that while they were advanced and, you know, a pretty good little race, the Snakemen drew him underground, under Snake Mountain, and he's the last of his kind. And while he does look pretty mean there, he's actually pretty smart, and it says he is a mathematician. So, yeah, there's me right there. So, pretty much imagine that in his people, his race of beings, he is a blue arachnid version of Isaac Newton meets Houdini, because he is the master of escape. So, packaging here, you got your belly button, you got your lightning bolts, Grayskull all the way around, all this fun little stuff all through here, you see in this. If you want to see his full bio, though, it's over there, okay? So let's get him open. And there you have Webstor. Now, I do have a few minor complaints with him. I guess you would call them minor. Some people probably call them major. I really do like how he looks. I think this blue is a perfect shade. It's something different. Most of the guys, you know, they're all just flesh-colored, or with Merman, he's that kind of green. Webstor has this nice deep blue, and I really do like it. Look at this gun here, and I'm catching this at the corner of my eye. But you see the inside little chamber there of his rifle has this nice little glittery effect. And I'm going to say that's kind of an energy type of thing. You can see it's a lot different from the rest of the rifle. It's nice and glittery. Everything else is just kind of flat. And it looks like if you can get his hands right, you may be able to have him holding his gun, his rifle with two hands. Although, that's kind of hard to do there. You can't really do much posing with that. So you're going to just have to stick it up and do the one-handed shoot there. I like it. It's not bad. You take his rifle and you can just kind of put it aside. There you go. Now, going off, taking the whole aspects of the original 80s cartoon and the 2002 series and kind of everything in between, you got his backpack here. The original Webstor toy, I'm going to call him Webstor because it's funny, had this nice little gimmick, and I, as you can tell, I have everything kind of all twined up here, but it had this gimmick where you could pull his grapple hook out, kind of hang him on something, and then push a button, give a little tug, and he would climb up it. A nice little kind of effect. But sadly this time, it's just, he got your hook here, and mine was very, very bent out of the packaging. I mean, that's how it is. It was just in there. And it's this little, really thin plastic. It's just, it's really bendable. That's definitely not a pretty thing. But you can pull it, and then you have to just let it dangle. And then once that's up, you can pull this line and retract it. I definitely would have liked if they had done some kind of gimmick where push a button, it'll automatically pull itself in. I don't know why they didn't. I mean, there's plenty of toys that have this kind of gimmick. I would like if it could have been done. But I'm hoping there's some kind of customizer out there who will take this apart, have a toy that has that gimmick. I know Animated Black Arachnia has it. The original Webstor has it. Find that little gimmick and make it work for this guy, because if you could have it where his grapple could fit inside, all packed away, flawless figure, it'd be perfect. But the fact that it has this little thing going, it really just take away from the figure. I mean, you're stuck with having all this rope just kind of dangling behind him, or if you work it out where where he's holding his hook, and I know it's not going to look too perfect, but if you have him even holding his hook, you know, the line's just going to get in the way. There's so little you can really do with it, unless you just wrap it around him and all that kind of stuff. And you may just want to pull the hook off. Seriously, you may want to cut it off and just call it a day. However, the hook can store in this little slot back here. Just kind of push it in place. And he'll hold it, and you have this kind of thing going. So there's that. Now, also going from the 2002 series, they've included his four other legs here, which are part of the backpack. And I think it really does improve the figure even more, just giving these little extra limbs. Makes him a lot more spider-like, you know, give him eight legs, you know. And I do like it. Now, however, if you do want to have the legs kind of hidden, you can take them and kind of squeeze them down. This one of mine is a lot more stiff than the other, so you may want to kind of be careful with it. But you can have the legs pulled down and give them a kind of concealed look. So you don't have to have that in place. Or if you want, you can just take the whole thing apart, and it fits in there really securely. When you actually put it in place, it clicks, it locks in. Or you can pull his backpack off and just go with this little look. It definitely doesn't look bad. The armor still stays in place. No problem at all. I do like it. Now the armor, you can pull it off without having to remove his head. Just kind of give him a little pull, a little squeeze. Slide this out. Fits on just as easy. Just pop it on and you're all set. Now, one thing that I'm really glad to see, pictures really didn't do this guy justice as far as I'm concerned. He has this nice little shading all through his body. And it may not come through that well on here because I have all this crazy light, but he has this nice shading that I can see. It makes everything look a lot more three-dimensional, a lot more, I guess, realistic. However, you may notice his face, while it does look rather nice, it has this kind of glossy tint to it that the rest of his body doesn't have. And I don't like that there's such a contrast in there between the head and the body. Again, I'm not sure how well this is really coming out, but it has this really glossy look to it. And the body is kind of shiny, but definitely not that oily. Yeah, but that's it. In terms of articulation, I mean, it's like all the others. The arms can swing outwards. They can rotate all the way around. They can rotate the shoulders. He has an elbow joint. His wrist can spin all the way around. His fingernails are painted, which I think is always a nice little touch when they actually put multiple tones of paint on them. His torso has this action going on. And one thing that I do notice, and I don't remember seeing this too badly on the other guys, but he has this kind of black flat thing right in the middle of him. I don't remember that on the other guys. So I maybe just missed it, but I don't like that. But anyway, his waist is supposed to rotate. They all do, but mine, it is extremely stiff. I mean, it's not budging. So I don't know if it's just really tight, if it's glued in place or what. But on mine at least, the waist will not rotate, and I'm not really sure why. But anyway, onto his legs, they can swing outwards. They can swing forward, they can swing back, quite a bit on him, compared to the other ones. His knee joint does feel a little bit loose, but he does have knees. His shins can rotate here, his ankles have movement there. And last but not least, his head does have full movement all the way around. Look him up, look it down, side to side, tilty. He has all the basics, all the fun parts of articulation. And I do like Webstor. I like him quite a bit, actually. However, I just don't like the whole grapple. I wish there was some kind of gimmick where you could retract it. I really do. And the fact that you can't really takes away from the toy. It definitely does stink that his hook is this kind of rubbery type thing. I mean, it's just the handle. The actual hook part are pretty stiff, pretty solid. It's just this actual part here is just so flimsy. It feels like if you do have him posed somewhere for a period of time, it will continue stretching. You see mine. I mean, that's, I'll have to actually boil that to actually get it back to its original shape. But however, if you are someone who's just going to have him on a shelf somewhere, have him hanging from something, you really shouldn't have a problem with him. He looks great. He looks fantastic. He is the master of escape. He's Webstor, and he looks fantastic. I definitely like these figures still. Very few complaints. I have a few here and there, like the whole gloss effect on his head, but honestly, I do like him. So now let's see how it looks with the others. Yeah. If you ask me, Webstor fits in pretty perfectly with the boys. So there you go, guys. Hope you enjoyed the video. Hope you have a great day, and I will see you around. Take care.